At least 13 people in Bangladesh have been killed and 4.5 million affected by floods triggered by heavy rains, the Disaster Management and Relief Ministry said on Friday. The South Asian nation of 170 million people, crisscrossed by hundreds of rivers, has seen frequent floods in recent decades. It is among the countries most vulnerable to disasters and climate change, according to the Global Climate Risk Index. Nearly 190,000 others were taken to emergency relief shelters, according to the sources. Altogether, 11 of the country's 64 districts were affected by the flooding. Feni, about 100 kilometers or 60 miles northwest of the main port city of Chittagong, was worst hit. Floods triggered by torrential rains have swamped low-lying areas in Bangladesh, according to the government's challenges after weeks of political turmoil. As red, white, and blue balloons streamed onto a Chicago stage and people danced in the aisles, Kamala Harris waved to supporters and basked in the crowd's adulation after the speech of her political life. As she accepted the party's nomination in the U.S. presidential race yesterday, nearly every sentence Harris uttered was greeted by raucous cheers, her voice reverberating around the packed auditorium. The full-to-capacity crowd waved vertical Harris banners in the thousands in support of the nominee, who wore a dark jacket set off with a matching cravat and a U.S. flag lapel pin.
Defend our forces and our interests against Iran and Iran-backed terrorists. I will not cozy up to tyrants and dictators like Kim Jong-un who are rooting for Trump. Because, you know, they know he is easy to manipulate with flattery and favors. They know Trump won't hold autocrats accountable because he wants to be an autocrat himself.
Also on the last day of the Democratic Convention, civil rights activist Al Sharpton and the Central Park Five, the group of black and Latino boys falsely convicted over the rape of a jogger in New York whose prosecution Donald Trump promoted, endorsed Kamala Harris and Tim Walz. Ardent supporters wearing Madame President t-shirts spontaneously broke out into applause, cheering wildly before anyone had even taken to the stage. South Africa's ruling ANC on Monday expelled its former leader, ex-president Jacob Zuma, for leading a rival party in two elections following disciplinary proceedings. The African National Congress, which lost its absolute parliamentary majority for the first time in May, largely due to Zuma's defection, said the veteran politician's conduct was irreconcilable with its constitution. The ANC first suspended the scandal-tainted ex-leader in January after he endorsed the newly formed Mkhonto Weziwe. MK cut into the ANC's share of votes in the May 29th elections, taking third place with 14.5%. Zuma has been barred from serving as an MP because of a 2021 conviction for contempt of court.
One day, when I'm an old man, because now I'm very young. I will tell the citizens of this country that you sold out by creating other organizations, helping the enemy to disperse us so that we don't have a concrete majority. Because that's what is done with these little parties that we've been establishing, all of us.
After the news of his upcoming expulsion was leaked, the party lashed out at the grave injustices against its leader. Zuma will engage legal counsel to determine the course of action, he said. The former president has 21 days to appeal the decision. Zuma joined the ANC via its youth league as a teenager in 1959.